Hello students, welcome to EPG Paathshala. I am Dr. Savita Sharma from University of Delhi. Today, we are going to discuss the module Thin Films Gas Sensing Application under the paper Thin Film Science and Technology. So students, let us see what we are going to learn in this module. First of all, we are going to study about the gas sensor. That what is a gas sensor and having its detailed definition. Then secondly, we'll study about the strain gauge, and then we'll see the preparation of strain gauges. Next, we are going to learn about the characteristics of a good sensor. Then we'll see that why there is a need of a gas sensor. Then we'll study in detail about the gas sensing parameters. Then we'll see the history and development of gas sensors. Then we'll study the gas sensing mechanism. Then next we'll study about the chemiresistive sensors and their fabrication. So before we go into the detail, let's have an introduction that actually what is a gas sensor. Sensor is a device that measures change in physical, chemical or biological quantity and converts it into a signal which can be measured or read by an instrument or observer. Therefore, sensor is a transducer that converts a non-electrical signal value or the non-electrical value which can be physical or chemical quantity to preferably an electrical value that can be measured. So let's discuss what is a strain gauge. Strain gauge is a device that is used to measure strain on an object. It was invented by Arthur C. Roque and Edward E. Simons in 1938. Since 1938, metal foil gauges have been used extensively for measuring strain. These metal foil gauges have gauge factor in the range 2 to 4. Also, these gauges possess low sensitivity to strain. These gauges have to be bonded on some support structure by the means of adhesives. Transducer industry have been looking for a better and cheap alternative to foil gauges for last two decades. Thin film deposited by vacuum deposition technique exhibits strong piezoresistive meaning semiconductor strain gauges used for measuring small strain called piezoresistors. So exhibits strong piezoresistive properties. Amorphous xoid materials exhibit strain sensitivity 5 to 50 times higher than metal foil gauges. Aerospace industry is still the main user of this technology. The main technological application in the field of strain study are the turbine blade temperature measurement, the study of compressor blade strain, and the study of bound layer states. Since thin film sensor have very less thermal mass and thus have fast response rate, thin film sensor techniques are being utilized. So the next heading or the next topic is the preparation of strain gauge. Resistance strain gauge thin film sensor can be made by adherent depositing thin metal films over non-conducting layer which are in turn deposited on some base material. A typical dynamic strain gauge sensor consists of 10 micrometer of aluminium oxide deposited by physical method onto a polished blade surface, followed by nickel 20% chromium gauge mix and lead out track having thickness of 1 micrometer. To reduce the unwanted resistance, the lead out track is overcoated with 1 micrometer of gold. The lead out track and the sensor grid are overcoated with 1 to 2 micrometer of aluminium oxide, which acts as a mechanical protective coating. The patterning of sensor grid and lead out track is done by standard photolithographic process. Thin film strain gauges have maximum overall thickness of 12 micrometer, which is 25 times thinner than conventional ceramic cement gauges. This greater thickness of the conventional gauges is sufficient to disturb the airflow over the component, making it less sensitive as compared to thin film strain gauge sensor. In the technology area, where the gradients of both stress and temperature would be present and require minimum aerodynamic effects, always in these cases, thin film strain gauge sensor is preferred. Recently, NASA Glenn Research Center has developed thin film strain gauges which can work at higher temperature also. The picture of their final product is shown below, in which palladium chromium thin film strain gauge on a turbine engine oil test specimen is shown. These thin film gauges provide the extra advantage of minimally intrusive surface strain measurements, which not seems viable in conventional method, and give highly repeatable readings of strain measurements with low drift at temperatures from room temperature to 1100 degrees Celsius. This product is a 300 degrees Celsius advance in operating temperature over the palladium chromium wire gauge and 500 degrees Celsius advance over the commercially available gauges made of other materials. So let us now discuss about the characteristics of good sensor. The characteristic of the good sensor, the number one, the main characteristic is the highly sensitive to the input stimulus. That is, a good sensor should be highly sensitive and insensitive to other interfering stimulus. That is the good selectivity. That means the first main characteristic is the high sensitivity and good selectivity. Secondly, a good sensor should be capable of measuring very low concentration of stimulus. That is, it should have a low detection limit. Thirdly, a good sensor should give fast response and recovery time, meaning it should give result quickly. Number four, a good sensor should be portable and wireless. Number five, a good sensor should have a linear output signal with respect to the amount of stimulus. That is, it should have a good linearity. Number six, a good sensor should be robust to harsh environments such as pressure, temperature, humidity, etc. That is, a good sensor should be highly stable. Number seven is, a good sensor should have a similar response over repeated cycles. That is, it should have a good repeatability. Number eight, a good sensor should have or should give similar response by sensing element fabricated under different batches, meaning a good sensor should be highly reproducible. Number nine, a good sensor should have same response characteristic over a long period of time. That is, a good sensor should have a high shelf life. And lastly, a good sensor should have a low operating temperature and low power consumption. So while designing a sensor, care must be taken to achieve most of the above mentioned characteristics. Various sensor structures have been designed for the detection of different stimuli and few are available in the commercial market also. In the present module, the main focus is on the development of sensors where the stimuli are gas molecules. That is, we are going to focus on the gas sensing application of the thin film sensors. Now let us see why there is a need of gas sensor. Recent technological advancements have adverse effects on mankind, including environmental, that is the air pollution, due to rapid industrialization, chemical pollution due to increased use of pesticides in agriculture, and some unforeseen effects of genetically modified foodstuff affecting the health of living organisms as well as the ecosystem. Hence, efficient sensors are essentially required to detect these pollutants at the first step only. Nowadays, efforts are continuing towards the realization of smart and intelligent systems which combine sensors with necessary electronics to make a portable or wireless sensor. So after discussing about a sensor and seeing the characteristics of a good sensor, let us discuss about the gas sensing parameters. The first most important parameter is the sensing response. The sensing response, which is denoted by S of a semiconductor gas sensor, towards a target gas at a given temperature T is determined from the measured values of resistances of the sensing element. Say, for example, if the matrix is the tin oxide thin film, the resistance in the presence of atmospheric air is denoted by RA, and the resistance in the presence of target gas is denoted by RG. The sensor response for a reducing target such as sulfur dioxide gas is defined as S is equal to RA minus RG divided by RG. If RA, that is the resistance in air, is much higher than RG, which is the resistance in gas, for reducing target gas, the response to a good approximation is RA divided by RG. Figure below shows the typical sensing response of a semiconductor thin film based gas sensor with temperature for a specific concentration of target gas. For a typical sensor, the response increases with increase in temperature, attaining a maximum response, which is denoted by S max, at a temperature known as operating temperature, that is the T opt for the sensor, and decreases thereafter with further increase in temperature. Hence, the operating temperature is the temperature at which the sensor gives the maximum response towards a known concentration of target gas. The figure 3 given here shows the typical variation of sensor response with temperature for a semiconductor gas sensor. Temperature of the sensing element being on the x-axis and the sensor response on the y-axis. And we can clearly see that at the T operating, or the operating temperature, the sensor response is maximum. The next sensing parameter is the response time. The time taken by the sensor to acquire the 90% of its minimum value of resistance in the presence of target reducing gas from the high RA value is known as response time. That we can see clearly in the figure 4 given below. The next parameter is the recovery time. Recovery time is the time taken by the sensor to reacquire about 10% lower value of its initial resistance in the presence of atmospheric air. From the lower RG value is considered as the recovery time. In the figure 4 given, we can see clearly the response time and the recovery time, and we can see from the curve that when the gas is introduced, the resistance of the element, the sensing element, falls down to the value, to a stable value, which is called as RG, that is the resistance in the presence of gas. And when the gas is flushed out, again that value RG is changed towards the initial value RA. The time required to acquire this minimum value of RG is called the response time, and the time taken by the sensor to reacquire about the 10% lower value from RG is called as the recovery time. So let us now see the history and current status of gas sensors. There are number of applications of thin film in the field of technology and devices beneficial for nature and mankind. Among these devices and technology, gas sensors are one of the most advantageous technology which humans are using, and also monitoring environment and health at a very large scale. Research interest on making gas sensor can be seen from the figure given here, which shows the number of publications issued in the interest of fabricating gas sensor. So now let us discuss about the chemiresistive sensors. A chemiresistive sensor is the one which changes its electrical resistance when there is a change in the nearby chemical environment. Chemiresistive sensors are class of chemical sensor that rely on the direct chemical interaction between analyte and the sensing material. This chemical interaction between the analyte and the sensing material can be done by hydrogen bonding, covalent bonding, or molecular recognition. There are several different materials which shows chemiresistive properties, such as semiconducting metal oxides, conducting polymers, and nanomaterials like graphene, carbon nanotubes, some nanoparticles, some transition metal, dichalcogenides, etc. So in the given figure 6, we can see a basic schematic of a single gap chemiresistive sensor in which the sensing element is sandwiched between the two electrodes. A basic chemiresistive sensor consists of a sensing material and metal electrodes, where sensing element bridges the gap between interdigitated electrodes. In these circuits, sensing element is in the form of thin film deposited by various physical and chemical route. Interdigitated electrodes are also deposited thin film of metals such as titanium or platinum and gold in general. Metallic heater made up of thin films are also integrated in the circuit whenever required. The resistance between the electrodes can be easily measured with the help of multimeter. The sensing material has some inherent resistance that is being modulated by the absence or presence of the analyte. During exposure of target analyte, for which sensing element has been grown, target analytes interact with the sensing material. These interactions cause changes in the resistance value, which is being monitored continuously using multimeter having precise accuracy. These sensors are based on semiconducting metal oxide thin films, which are gas sensitive material. Number of metal oxides are being used for this purpose depending on the planned application and required temperature for adsorption of planned gas to measure the significant response. Semiconducting metal oxide thin film sensors are one of the most widely researched and study group of chemiresistive gas sensor. Metal oxide sensors are primarily used as gas sensor since they can sense oxidizing gases and reducing gases both, this remarkable property makes them ideal to be used as gas sensors. Metal oxide sensors require high temperatures to operate because an activation energy must be overcome in order for resistivity to change after the interaction with the analyte. The critical part of any sensor system is sensing element, and research is always on to design superior sensor as compared to the one which is already in market in terms of selectivity and sensitivity, etc. In order to fabricate most sensitive sensing layer, a great deal of research and development is required, and here comes the biggest advantages of using thin films for fabricating sensing layer, because the physical and chemical processes for growing thin film offers many parameters to play for depositing high quality thin film gas sensor, which will give best response for target gas molecule. In order to make sensor system cheaper, portable and usable for monitoring target gas molecule, it should require lower power for its operation. It should be compatible with sampling system. It should not require any external carrier or reactant gases. It should be made as small as possible, and if possible, it should be compatible with microelectronic technology. Keeping above listed requirement in mind, currently tin oxide based gas sensor are being utilized for targeting various gases. So now let us discuss one of the sensing mechanism, which is the spillover mechanism. Here we are taking the example of tin oxide as the thin film, which is used for the gas sensing application. And the metal catalyst can be anything, let's say palladium, platinum, etc. So we are going to discuss the sensing mechanism, that is the spillover sensing mechanism, over the tin oxide thin film. So the presence of catalyst on the surface of tin oxide thin film, especially in the form of clusters, may influence the oxygen adsorption activity at higher temperature, and therefore modulates the space charge region at the surface of grain boundaries of tin oxide thin film. So in this case, we have taken the tin oxide thin film, and over that we have deposited the catalyst, that is the metallic catalyst, in the form of nanoclusters. Then this is the sensing structure, that is the tin oxide thin film having the metal nanoclusters as the catalyst. Now this sensor structure is now given the exposure of the gas that is need to be sensed. So now we are going to discuss the mechanism, that is the sensing mechanism of the target gas over this sensor structure having the catalyst. The oxygen atom present in air undergoes a spillover process in the presence of catalyst on the surface of uncovered tin oxide thin film at moderate temperatures. The figure 7 shows the schematic diagram of the process and the interaction between the atmospheric oxygen and catalyst cluster would be expressed by the following reaction. We can see the metal that reacts with the atmospheric oxygen and gives twice of metal is to one oxygen atom. And then these metal and oxygen atoms gives the metal ion and the oxygen ion. At elevated temperatures, the oxygen molecules from the atmosphere are adsorbed and are weakly bonded on the surface of catalyst clusters. The resulting complex, that is M2O, subsequently dissociates the oxygen atoms. The figure given here shows a schematic diagram of the process and interaction between the atmospheric oxygen and catalyst clusters. The dissociated oxygen atoms spill over the catalyst clusters on the uncovered surface of tin oxide or any metal oxide thin films, become negatively charged, surface ions after capturing electrons from the conduction band of MO2 or metal oxide. The presence of excess adsorbed oxygen increases the width of space charge region or the potential barrier at the surface or grain boundaries of tin oxide thin film, and a much higher value of sensor resistance RA is obtained. So in the end, we have a table describing the favorable metal oxides for detecting selective gas vapors. So this table summarizes the various metal oxides that can be used for the sensing of the suitable gas vapors or the selective gas vapors. So some of them are chromium titanium oxide for the detection of H2S gas, that is the hydrogen sulfide. Then the gallium oxide detects or senses the oxygen or the carbon monoxide gas. Indium oxide is useful for sensing of ozone. Molybdenum oxide senses the ammonia gas. Then tin oxide is generally used for all the reducing gases and can be made selective towards certain reducing gas by using a metal catalyst over it. As in the previous slide, we see that tin oxide thin film having the palladium or platinum metal nanoclusters as the catalyst can be used towards a particular gas detection. The next example is the tungsten oxide towards the NO2 gas sensing. Then next is zinc oxide for hydrocarbons and oxygen. So students, let us now summarize what we have learned in this module. First of all, we have known or we have concluded that what is a gas sensor. Then we learned about the strain gauge and the fabrication of strain gauges. Then we studied about the characteristics required for a good sensor or the various parameters that should be satisfied for a sensor to be called as a good sensor. Then we studied about why there is a need of gas sensor. What is the reason that we require to fabricate the complicated assembly for monitoring the various toxic gases in our environment. Then next we studied about the various parameters that we study while doing the gas sensing, which are called as the gas sensing parameters. Then next we saw the historical and the current development of the gas sensors. Then next we studied in detail about the chemiresistive sensors and their fabrication. Then next we studied one of the gas sensing mechanism, which is the spillover mechanism, by taking an example of tin oxide thin film decorated with metal nanoclusters as the catalyst. The metal nanoclusters here can be the platinum, palladium or any other metal, for taking the selectivity of the tin oxide towards a particular target gas. Then in the end, we saw the examples of favorable metal oxides for detecting selective gas vapors. Thank you.